Hi everyone! Happy Saturday night! I wasn't going to do this video, I was gonna go live, but then I was just like, I had like a really bad day with like trying to figure stuff out with my whipped ice cream toppers for my tumblers. It was just not even happening. It wasn't happening. I was just like, oh my god, what the hell is going on? So I'm just going to do this so I can concentrate, listen to my 80s music in the background, right? So I told a customer of mine that I wanted to go live so I can answer a lot of questions for everybody, but there's just too many customers that are ordering and stuff, and I just don't want to lose everything and lose track of what I'm doing and stuff like that. It's really easy for me to do that. But I am going to do these two skulls. I'm going to show you an example. Where did I put it? Where'd it go? There it is. Oh. Excuse my background. I do work out of my house. My apartment, rather. This is a glow-in-the-dark skull that I did a couple years ago. And it turned out really super cute. I love them, right? Yeah. So, I got an order to do a pink one and a green one. So, that's what we are going to do tonight. If I feel a little bit more uppity, I did do this purple and orange glitter for a Halloween base tumbler. And if anybody, listen, I'm just going and going, you guys. So if anybody wants this one, I have yet to like do a really couple coats of epoxy on here, do a little maybe black. Listen, my swirls are nice. I don't mind working with glitter. The thing is, when you're working with glitter, is you have to do a couple coats of Mod Podge, then do a couple coats of glitter and sand it and sand it and sand it, then do like three layers of epoxy. Ah! So you kind of go nuts with it a little bit. But this turned out really cool. I mean, I love it. And this just looks really cool just with the glitter. But when you put that epoxy on, it's going to like shine and make it look like glass. It's going to be gorgeous. So it's up for grabs if anybody wants it. And I will do a, you guys, y'all been asking me for, hold on a second. Show you the cool I'm talking. Where is it? Ah! Excuse my background, everyone. What'd I do it? Where's my other one? Okay. So here's my example lid right here. And if you want like some chocolate drizzle, and cute little candies in here, I just got a shitload of like M&Ms and oh my god, a ton of stuff, you guys. So if you want any goodies in your Cool Whip topping, just let me know. This is just an example, only because like right here, I didn't like that little indent right there. I'm super picky. So if you request something and it doesn't turn out the way you want it, I will fucking redo it over and over again. I'm not even shitting you guys. Not even shitting you. Okay, so there's that. And then this is the one I get a lot of requests for. Let's go this way. These are my coffee cups. What I basically do, oh my god, I'm losing my chair. Hold on. My kitchen goes like this. Oh my god. So I basically turn this into this. Yay. So I can either paint it, spray paint it. I do whatever. Depends on what your requests are and your design. And then I do whatever. And then I put these little babies on there. I can put a lot more. I can make it a little bit higher. Yes. And these tops are for actual tumblers, but they fit on my coffee mugs. So I'm super happy about that. And so you can, here is the little hole. Here's the hole where you put your straw. They're drinkable. Okay. These are dishwasher safe. Wash these tops. Wash these tops with just lukewarm water. Not real hot. Just lukewarm water. And go over it very, very gently. And just leave it out to dry on a towel. And then it'll be good to go. Okay. So there, and that's with all my ice cream Quip tumblers. Yes. Okay. And that's for my coffee mugs. And they are, oh, I don't have my price list in front of me. But they are, I believe, 16. So 13. Yes, I think they're 13 plus a lid is 16 with the Cool Whip topping, if you would like one. If you just like this, it's $13. Yeah. Okay. Your choice of two colors, maybe three, depending on colors. I have a lot of customers like, can you do purple and green and orange? I'm like, no. I'm going to tell you why. It's because purple and green, they look great together as a glitter. What's happening with my hair? Purple and green look good as a glitter, but if you mix them with epoxy, it's going to turn muddy and a brown. Yeah. Green is a horrible color to work with epoxy and purple, both of them. I mean, you just have to pick the right colors in yellow. Oh, I'm going to say, yeah, yellow, purple, green, and blue are really hard to work with. So I'm looking into it, and I'm ordering some cool stuff. So when I drop my inks in my epoxy, it's not going to mix all together like this. It's just going to, like, stay separated with all the colors. So I am looking into that with an awesome person. Yeah. So, okay. So if anybody wants any of these for now, Dave, I know I got you. I'm still going to make your blue and gold one. I've been super busy. So there's that. Okay. So I just wanted to go over all with all that stuff. Okay. So getting down to the nitty gritty. Tara? I'm going to make your pink and green skulls right now. Okay. These are glow in the dark, y'all. These are glow in the dark. And these are $20. Plus shipping and handling, depending on where you are in the United States. If it's really long, long distance, it can be between $10 and $13, $14, $15 for shipping. So keep that in mind. And the weight is really, this is heavy. And this is a lot of epoxy. I haven't done this in like, this has been like a year and a half since I did this. So I'm thinking around 8 ounces, a little over 8 ounces to make this skull. Okay. So let's go. Let's get our gloves. And here are our two colors, green and pink. Okay. And it is all glow in the dark. With this one, I did the glow in the dark first, and then up on top, I just did like a cool black. You can do whatever solid color or whatever. But let's go this route. Oh my god, there's like black gnats flying everywhere. I can't. Oh my god. Okay, so I'm gonna go, hold on, give me a second. Okay, so really quick, you just wanna clean your molds out with some paper towels, clean your cups out. You don't want any dust, cat hair, which I have everywhere. Clean them out. You don't want no particles or anything getting in there. Trust me, they will get stuck in here. I can't even tell you how many times I have had to start over and a whole thing of an epoxy would be wasted. So just make sure you clean everything out really good because you have to start over. And then guess what? Your customer has to wait another week for shit to get done. So let's not try to do this weekend. Good God, please, Lord, don't let me do this. Don't let me have anything else go wrong today. Oh, it's just glitter on the top. Okay, I just wanna have fun. So, I had to order a couple more of these because, I had two of these, but my other one, it just fucked up and, just tore. It was ridiculous. These seem like a little bit more stern and tougher, like the mold, the silicone, so, just making sure there ain't nothing in here. Because these glow-in-the-darks are light, and if you see anything, you will see everything in it, like cat hair, anything in here. So I'm just trying to make sure it's just not on the inside, it's just on the outside. It's driving me insane. So I work with glitter all day, you guys, all day. Ugh. Crazy. All right, so that's all clean. The cups are all clean. I'll be back. Okay. Never mind. It's just too funny. All right. Y'all got a drink? What is this? Peppermint schnapps, blueberry schnapps, and cranberry juice. Super, super good. Okay. Grab a drink. Let's go. Okay, so first we're going to grab our epoxies. This is going to be a full 8 ounces of pink and a full 8 ounces. We might even need a little bit more with these. I can't even remember the last time. I remember about... I know it was definitely a full cup. It took a lot of epoxy. These two cost like $60, you guys. It's ridiculous. Yeah, ridiculously costly. All right, let's go with the 8 first. All right, so we're gonna do 4. Okay. I'm gonna go this one. Yeah, because we're gonna do them at the same time. So if you work with epoxy resin, you have a 40 minute time limit. Once that 30 to 40 minutes goes by, it's gonna get extremely hot in that cure. So you have to be really careful of that, okay? Thank you. I may have to mix up a little bit more. Not really sure. I'm hoping it fills up the whole thing. Like I said, I haven't done one of these in a while. Thank you for your request, Tara. Let me know how to pronounce that, please. And your tumbler, I had to ask you your favorite colors. I know you said surprise you, but I at least need to know your favorite colors. I didn't want to send you something like, oh my God, this looks like hell. You know what I mean? So, thank you. Okay. All right, and we're gonna do 4 ounces for B. Same with this one. My God, that light is bright. Okay, ow! Big eye. This has been one hell of a damn Saturday. I'll tell you what. It's just been mishap after mishap. I mean, experimenting with certain things that I'm trying to do and get together has just been fucking ridiculous. Oh my God. Okay. Grab your popsicle sticks. Give it a stir. You have to stir these. I'm going to like put down pause. You just stir these for like 3 or 4 minutes. So I'm going to put down pause on. Okay, so I mixed up one. Which is this one. This one's already mixed. We'll mix the color in a minute. This one, I bought a mixer, a epoxy mixer, because I have carpal tunnel really bad. And so, this is my little mixer. Oh, my bad. Why is that? Did I not put my battery in there? Okay, don't ever purchase one of these from Amazon. They suck. Yeah. I don't even know the name brand, but I only used this like 3 times and the battery is still in there and it's not working. So yeah, I'm not happy about it at all. So don't purchase these. Just mix it with a big popsicle stick. Yay. Lord. I'm good. I don't know about this whole day. I don't even know about this whole weekend. What you guys think? Y'all having a good weekend? Me, on the other hand, you know. I am my son. Did I pronounce that right? Me and my son are going to The Price is Right at the Landmark Theater on October 4th. I'm super excited. We're both hoping either one of us wins. Yeah, it's going to be super fun. Okay. Yeah, this one's getting a little bit warm, so I just have to mix this up. I'm so curious right now. On top of, like, looking for it, I was like, why isn't this not working? I'm not buying any more batteries for this. Like, I'm not ordering this one anymore. There has to be a better deal out there somewhere. I got that from Amazon. Don't order it from Amazon if you ever work with them. Because they work really good, right? It works really good. So you don't have to keep stirring and doing this and rotating with your wrist. It just kind of, like, does it itself. So I don't know. Whatever. It is what it is. I didn't change the 80s music, but then I don't know if this is any better. They are 80s, I mean, but I was hoping for like some roller skate music or disco dance music from Sportsorama. You know what I mean? If y'all are from Syracuse, you know Sportsorama. That was my best place to hang out ever. Good times on the skating floor and in the disco. Yeah, fun. Okay, enough chatting. All right, let me get all this stuff set up and I'll be right back. Okay, when you're switching out stuff and you work with epoxy resin, make sure that you change your gloves all the time. Because anything that's on your gloves, like any dust particles or anything, can fly into your epoxy resin. And you don't want that. Especially when you're working with bright colors like these. Okay. I need a drink. Hopefully Facebook doesn't snap that picture. For some reason, when I'm doing my YouTube channels and all this other stuff, they snap the coordinates, pictures of me with flies. Oh my god. Okay, so let's go. Let's do the pink first. Glow in the dark pink. That's all it is, guys. Glow in the dark pink. I got this from Amazon. I'm not sure about the company. There's so many companies, you guys, that sell mica powders, glow in the darks. Oh my goodness. I want to say this is, oh my god, I can't even see that, you guys. Even my glasses on, it's so dark in here. That's why I like doing my videos during the day. At night, I just get thrown off. Because it's like I have my light and everything, but I just don't like it. Ugh. Okay, let me put you. Oh shit, that just went flying everywhere. Oh. Okay, so we are going to take this, and we're just gonna add a little by little, and see what it looks like. And stir it up. A lot of times with these powders, you have to make sure they are definitely like mixed up. Otherwise, you are definitely going to get clumps in your epoxy when you pour it, and you don't want that. Okay, so just keep an eye out for that. These black gnats are flying everywhere, and it's like pissing me off. And so it's a lot easier when you're working with a smaller, like a little cup, and you're like doing it. But when you're working with big amounts like this, it takes a little bit of time. Another one bites the dust. How? Another one bites the dust. Alicia, how you doing, girl? If you're watching, hopefully you're doing okay. You can get in touch with me anytime you need to, girl. All you guys, any one of you, you need a shoulder to cry on, a ear to listen to, I'm here. Ugh. All right. So the pink is pretty much done. I think I'm going to add a little bit more. Just a little bit more. I want it to be really pink in the skull. Sometimes it could just be like a really light pink. Excuse me. So you never know. You never know. So I just want to make it a really, really cool pink. Hopefully this is enough, you guys. Okay. Let's put that to the side and let's do, really? All right, more gloves. So everyone, I'll announce it later. I mean, it's still early. I'm going to my supervisor, I guess you can call it that. My supervisor at where I work. She gives like a benefit thing for her daughter. She has special needs, and so she does a special needs thing every October. And so she invited me to go and purchase my stuff and make a table and get a space for myself. It's gonna be at Monterey's, I believe, October 24th, 9:30 to 5:30, I believe. I have to look more into it, but I'll definitely put a thing up. Okay, so I will be there as well, selling all my stuff, everything. So super excited about that. Okay. All right. I'm going to do the green now. I want to put a lot of green in here, actually. Yeah. Make sure this pink. This pink looks awesome. I have to get it into the mold fairly quick because it's been about 40 minutes so far. 35 minutes since I've done this. So let's get this all mixed up. These are both glow in the dark, y'all. Both glow in the dark. Green and pink. These are mica powders from Amazon. All right, let me finish this up. Then I don't want to take up no more. Let me just finish mixing this and then we'll pour them into them bad boy skulls. All right, y'all. Gonna pour these babies in there. Oh, get up out of this chair. Get this out of the way. Oh my god, I'm never gonna get in Chandler World ever again. Stop rolling!
Okay.
Or I'm never gonna get a freaking chair with wheels on it. Green and pink. Awesome colors. All right, let's do pink first. Hold on, I need to spray my, hold on. Well, there goes my cap, freaking running away. I just want to wipe off my gloves real quick. Alright, I am going to spray the inside of the skull just to make any bubbles that are inside these to hopefully disappear. Here we go. Gotta be cool. Put this over here. Oh, hold on. See? That's what I'm saying. Mishaps like this. Hate them. Ugh. It's so annoying.
Onondaga County Executive Ryan McMahon prioritizes the health and safety of our children, investing in accessible mental health services for
schools. Guess what I'm going to have to do, y'all? Struggling to make ends meet. I'm going to have to mix up more. I think what I'm going to do, don't freak out, okay? It's going to look cool anyway.
I'm Ryan McMahon.
I am going to have to mix because, oh my God, I'm going to have to mix a little bit more because it didn't fill up all the way. I wasn't sure, I haven't done this in a long time, so I'm going to do this and then I'm going to... mix some up real quick. I know you requested just pink and black, but guess what? I'm just gonna make the one batter of one color and put it on the bottom, okay? Hopefully you don't mind. Yeah, I have to. Otherwise it's not going to be right. All right, I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm mixing up some light green mica powder with epoxy resin. It's gorgeous. It's a real pretty green. And it makes everything look pearl. So it's definitely going to go in between all the glow in the dark green, but it's going to look cool. I mean, if you don't like it and it doesn't turn out good, honey, I will refund your money back. I will, trust me. But I think it's going to look really cool. But that's just my opinion. That's just what I like. That's my problem. It's like, oh, well, I like it, but what's the customer gonna like? You know. So, yeah. Ugh. I need new glasses. Like, my kids at work have, like, broke my glasses twice. Well, I mean, it's not their fault. Like, I put them down somewhere, like, in a chair on a table or on the floor. And they just sit on them or something. So, that's my fault. Look how pretty that is. Ooh. It's just, like, a real pretty pearl. It's gorgeous. It really is gorgeous, you guys. I love using this stuff. So I'm going to pour this on. Ooh, hello. I'm going to pour this on the rest, and hopefully it will fill up, at least up to the teeth. Okay. There we go. Super pretty. I love this mica powder. I can't get enough of mica powder. I use it on everything. I use it on my tumblers. I use it in my Cool Whips. I use it on everything here. Okay. Trying to just like pour it around. These things need a lot of mica or a lot of epoxy. Okay. Yeah. It should cover. It's. Let's see. Yeah. It's right down to the nitty gritty of the teeth, you guys. Ah! Okay. Let's stir up the pink. Now the pink. The pink mica powders are gorgeous, you guys. Gorgeous. Oh, I love them. I keep switching like the 80s. It's like, not what I really wanted to hear, but it's okay. I'm hoping. Yeah, I'm just hoping. Because if I waste all this epoxy resin, I'm going to be pissed. Because. Okay. Alright. I'm just figuring this out. Figuring it out. I never did an overlap like this. Normally I do like wait till it cures and then do like a second layer. But I'm trying it this way and I'm gonna hope. If not, I have to start all over again. Sorry, Tara. Tara, sorry. Okay. I'm so glad it fills right up to the teeth, you guys. Oh my god. Just enough. Just enough. But I'm going to tell you something. I'm not done. I will definitely do like a bottom layer for sure. Yeah. I'm not just going to leave it like that. Yeah. Got some little thingies in there. Okay, so normally I would torch this. I'm not going to torch it. Oh my god, that's gonna look amazing. I'm just gonna spray some alcohol to get the bubbles out. I like doing and it'll definitely take all the bubbles out. Just let it sit. 24 hours, you guys. There you go. And then I will post part two of taking them out. It's not going to be anytime soon. These take 24 hours, and it's 10 o'clock at night. So. At least, yeah, it's gonna be at least a day, a couple days. And also I have to make sure that it's curing the right way because I did mix a second thing of epoxy, and I'm not really sure how it's going to react to down here. So yeah, I'm gonna keep an eye on that. Other than that, yes. If y'all have any questions about any of my tumblers, the ice cream topping Cool Whip lids, anything, please hit me up in Messenger and we will go that route. I'll be happy to answer any questions. I'm going to place these over here. Okay. Let these cure. And I'll see y'all in the morning. Thank you for watching. Love you guys. No, I will see you the next day. Yeah, I'll see you the next day. I don't know what day that'll be. It could be tomorrow or it could be Monday. When these cure, I will show you. But any other things, if y'all, anybody's interested in this, This is gonna be super pretty, you guys. Once I get everything done on here and get the topper on. Oh, amazing! Alright, love you guys. Peace. I am going to add this tonight and then In the morning, I will post another video. If I can, I don't know, depending on how, if they cure or not, I don't think so. Probably like Sunday night, I will show you how these cure. It takes a couple days for these. It's a lot of resin, you guys. All right. Love you guys. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel, The Wannabe Artist. And please follow me here on Lori's Art. Thank you. Have a good night. Peace.